For Carl. Purcell at the half board. High slot. Kucherov scores. Nikita Kucherov.
33 seconds of zone time. Kucherov lets her fly. Rangers and scored his first time against them. He's got his second goal of the season. Hanging out in the high slot. But watch this pass. And I think the pass makes his whole play. Look as he saucers it between two defenders, Ward and Chimera. Kucherov just lets her fly. It's right in the wheelhouse.
Nikita Kucherov swoops in wide. Forehand, backhand with a tuck.
Oh, hello.
I told you this guy's got a...
Kucherov as he dragged it in off the backhand. He's tied the shootout at one.
As he comes in, takes it, goes back for it, and...
Round and round on the draw. Long blast. Orlov, he scores!
Never did see offense in their arsenal. A nice win of the draw, helped by Fair, and there's a slap shot. Sort of curls around everybody, and Mason already in the butterfly. Good work by Ward, Beagle, and Fair winning that draw. And there it is, curving around everybody right into the net. Look at that shot. Had a little mustard on that.
Yes, Savard. It's all over Brendan Morrow. Morrow fights the position in front of the net. Savard trying to hold him off. And Morrow completely blocking the view there of McKenna. The Blues have a power play.
Well, that's it. Yeah. Talk about Morrow. Look at right down in front of that. He finds his way to take away the eyes of Mike McKenna. And that went right over top of that glove side of the goaltender. You give the shooter a lot of credit. Tarasenko, he finds the back of the net to make it a 3-2 hockey game. Power play goal for the St. Louis Blues. Not much Mike McKenna can do.
Long lead pass cut off there by Chilton. Draws it. He scores! Better Chilton with a blast from the left point. It may have been rejected and deflected, excuse me, in front of the net, but the Jackets now have the lead.
A little soft dump in tight, and then you bang, and then you crash. And that's what the Jackets did. They got the forecheck going, forced them to turn the puck over, and then a shot by Tootin. Beautiful job by the forechecking unit of that fourth line, but then the shot looks like it was deflected, but ends up beating the goal.
There's an easy mob on to Como. Como tried to walk to the front of that goal. An easy mob kept on the doorstep. You go to the dirty areas. Como flips a backhand and gives Como all the credit in the world. Hanging out of that puck, showing patience, and then handing to an easy mob.
Well, this is a man's game, and you can see again Como. He has the legs going tonight. What does he do? He starts to take it to those high traffic areas and then give credit to an easy mob. Stick on the ice. He out-muscles the defenseman in front of
the... Coach in National Hockey League history to reach that plateau. Currently sitting at 626. Jackets do not want to give him 627, but there's a goal. Tarasenko picks up that loose puck and beats McKenna. The Blues lead 1-0.
Well, they get that puck out high, and the one thing the Jackets tried to block that shot, and it's a fortuitous bounce that it comes right, and here's the view. Once you get inside the line, you can see the shot being taken from Bomeister, and the shot being taken off the rebound. Tarasenko follows up. That makes it a 1-0 game, but again, a lucky bounce.
Kunis looking for it, swept aside by Smith. The Red Wings look a little panicky on their PK right now. Malkin with it. The Jokinen in front. Malkin, he scores! Evgeny Malkin buries it, and the Penguins quickly take the 2-1 lead.
A sore neck if you're going to watch every pass. So precise. As they go down low, Jokinen tries to go across to Kunitz off a skate right to Malkin, and he's not going to miss. That's off a leg. That's off another leg. And the Penguins are just getting to loose pucks. Their power play, number one in the National Hockey League. And Malkin at
10. Oh, there's a high stick there on Jenner. Delay penalty. Jackets move up ice. Sixth attacker on, and Anisimov. There you go. A little payback. It's 2-0.
Oh, what a beauty. Maintain their composure again. They control deer. Basically, really high around the head of Jenner and then up the ice. Watch the play on that backside by Como, feeding Onisimov. That makes it a 2-0 game.
And that hit was from Dylan McElrath. The young kid just got called up from Hartford.
They moved the puck around and Onisimov puts it in.
Looking to get emotion, trying a big hit. He's a fighter, Bill and Jeff. And he went at it.
Toronto in before checking. McClendon. Played it along the boards. It got back a little bit near the line. Back in one. Sharp angle. Pull him in. Scores! Coleman with a pass. and the...
That's a way to come back after giving up a goal. Chicago Blackhawks defenseman running around a little bit. Just nice little pass by McClement coming up right here. Spot.
In front of the Dallas bench. There goes Nichushkin into the zone. Big Val getting free. Nichushkin in. A shot. He scores. Big Val makes it 2-1 Dallas.
And then he got roasted on this one. I think, again, trying to get a change in. He was motioning toward their bench. Had to step back to the middle of the ice. If you do that against Nichushkin, who hounds the puck, protects the puck, and slides it around Pavlik. Boy, what a beauty of a goal.
Hey, Jets, you can see the confusion. Dustin Byfuglien was out there for the entire power play. And so it's just, you lose your gap. There's nothing you can do. Nichushkin coming at you with speed. And he just finishes it. Poor Jacob Trouba. He was the guy that stepped on the ice, but just a bad.
And he lost his twig. Raymond comes in to Kulibin in the slot. And he scores with a great shot by Kulibin to make it 5-2.
A result of ring chance. He knocks it out of midair, but he doesn't get control of it, so it's not blown down for high stick. In Toronto, does play right there to Kulibin.
Kucherov giving the puck to Thompson. Carl's with him. He's going to hang on and does at the line. Thompson down the boards for Brown. Comes out in front. Kucherov turning. Goes forehand. Shoots. He scores! To the net to tie the game at one.
And that's one thing you can bet, too, that he's not going to be passed. Lightning get in there quick. Nate Thompson has had a tremendous game, and you see that harassment in the puck deflected off of T.J. Brown's stick right to Kucherov, and he just spun and let it.
There by Justin Schultz getting up in the rush, knowing that it was a line change waiting for fresh bodies.
Yakubov scores. Taylor Hall setting.
Nail Yakubov. Louis came in without a goal in his last eight, so you know he's feeling good about this.
And his first five-on-five.
Transition once again. Watch Taylor Hall beat the defenseman to this puck. He finds Yakubov in the high slot.
Returning to the lineup. Bertuzzi on the other side. A couple of big bodies with Datsyuk. Here's a chance. Put in front. Score. Pavel Datsyuk. I mean, that's just too easy. The Panthers. Poor coverage in their own zone, and that's a 2-0 Detroit.
And the Panthers just chasing too far and too easy for the Red Wings. Down and then Kopeski continuing down and just stop here, and as you just continue, Kopeski goes all the way, and then look at the room at the point, and there's where the breakdown ensues.
This goal is created by number 93, not only in the offensive zone, but he skates through the neutral zone with speed, curls up with a nice pass back to Erickson, delays beautifully. Great vision to find Erickson, who shot past, which is the toughest for a goalie to read. Playing the shot out, Thomas late getting across.
And they would have dinner at Jack Johnson's house, so he didn't have to eat that campus food. Here's Malkin driving to the net. Walks in, scores! Evgeny Malkin goes coast to coast.
Well, after a tiring shift by Crosby,
Johnson was tired.
And Tootin was flat-footed. Johnson couldn't get over to get Malkin in time. Tootin could not get through that left leg of Malkin. Don't you love how he protected that puck? He cut in like an alpine skier.
Bench, six attackers on in the final minute of regulation. Mason slugs it around. Ward is there to steal. Slot it for Ovechkin. Score!
Better. It's a bad play with the puck by Mason behind the net. Then he doesn't set himself up. Look at him struggle with the puck. He's behind the net. He's sliding to get out there, and by then it's too late. He's not set. He's not square. And wow, what a comeback for this Caps team.